Hello, today I'm here with a new video and today I am actually going through my face palettes and it might be a small decluttering in this one. So I'm going through my face palettes and I really hope that you will like this. So I think we can start with the blush and I got two blush duos that are from Kaleidos. It's these two. I think that these are discontinued and I don't know why I like them. So it's the Lo-Fi Duo Blushers. So this one is in Rose. So it has two. Yeah, because it's a duo. It is one matte and one shimmer. And I did receive these from Kaleidos in PR. So I really do like these. Maybe they are not that... What I heard, they are really like to lighter skin only and not suitable for darker skin tones. And so this is the swatches and I can see that this is not for everyone. Maybe I should hold on the mirror. I usually use this matte one. This shimmery one I don't use that much. I don't know why, but I like this. I've used it a lot during my Kaleidos week. So this is the rose one. And then this is the duo blusher in peach. And it is the same thing. It has one shimmer and one matte. I need to hold the mirror. And it is the same one with this. It is pretty like light. It works for me. I don't use the shimmer one that much, but I've used the matte one a lot and I think they were good for me. It's not my favorites, but I like them. So that is the one from Kaleidos. Next up I have this clown blush from Likely Makeup. This contains four blushes and these are really like pigmented and a little bit more fun blushes. I'm always a little bit afraid when I'm using this because it is that pigmented, but it's really good blushes and I think this is a really fun palette. I think I've used all actually. I think this Circus is my favorite, or this Contortion. It's a hard word. I can swatch these as well. And as you can see, these are so pigmented. I need to hold this down because I don't want to blend you with the mirror. As you can see, these are really pigmented and these are multifunctional, so you can use them for your eyes if you want to. But I think this is just such a fun, unusual blush palette and I'm really happy that I have it. So I think I will keep most of the things in this video. I don't think this will be a declutter. I just think it will be showing you my face palettes. So yeah, this I can really recommend this if you want some strong and more fun blushes. Then I have this palette from Lunar Beauty. This is the Moon Prism Blush. It has six shadows or shades and I love this one. This is like my favorite blush palette I own and some of my favorite blushes. I haven't used this Gravity because I think it's too dark for me, but all the others I use, I just like have to go in with a lighter hand when I use Space. But this is really amazing. This Stargaze is one of my absolute favorite blushes I own. I am so happy that I bought this palette. I just love it. And I'm going to swatch it for you, of course, my little horses. So these are the swatches and it's only this Soleil that is shimmery and I love that one, but I think Stargaze is my favorite. It is this one. Space is also really good. Twilight is also really good. Pink Moon is the lightest one and I don't think this will suit everybody. It works for me, but I think overall this is an amazing blush palette and it might come in my yearly favorites. I don't know because I haven't done that video yet, but I am so happy that I bought this and I can really recommend it. I think this is like all you need for blushes. You have something shimmery, you have something warm, you have something color, you have something dark, you have something light. I can recommend this palette because it is amazing. Then I was thinking that we can go into highlighters, and I will start with the first highlighter I bought, one of the first at least, and it is this one from Sleek. This is the Solstice palette. I actually think that I will decluttering this. It looks like this. I know that a lot of people have had this as a favorite because this is such an amazing palette and it's so, so cheap as well. This is a cream highlighter. I think I don't have used it. I've used this a lot. And yeah, this was like the first insanely highlighters I bought. I don't think I will swatch all of these highlighters because it is a lot, but maybe I can take like my favorite in all of the palettes, and it is this one. I don't know the name of this, but this is really like a super blinding highlighter. Mine is getting pretty old. I actually think that I will decluttering this. It looks like this. This is such a good palette if you want to try highlighters. And now I think you can hear Astrid. So this is a really good palette and I can recommend this, but I actually think that it will leave my collection because I haven't used it for so long and it's kind of old, so I'm actually going to decluttering this. So I'm guessing this will be a decluttering video as well. The next highlighting palette is this one. This is from Urban Decay and Christian Lian. It's Beauty Beam. It looks like this. It has three shades and I only used the middle shade because the other ones I think it's a little bit too dark for me. This middle shade is a love for me, and this palette, the mirror is always getting like, I don't know. So yeah, this middle shade, I don't think this has a name, but this is so, so good. I could easily buy the palette just for this one. And I don't know if Urban Decay has something like this still in their collection because this was a collab. But if you can find this one, I can really recommend it. It is really good. And you see this amazing highlight. I'm going to save this even though I only use one of the shades, but I love it so, so much. The next smaller palette I have is this highlight from Lion Crime. This is in Opals. I bought this because Jessica loved this one. And she's right. This is an amazing little highlighter palette. I think that the middle shade is my favorite, so I'm going to swatch it for you. And these are so creamy and they are so nice on the skin. And I really, really do love this one. They have a lot of different colors and I can really recommend this. If you don't want just this opal, this suits light skin, I would say, because I can use all the three. Just check the others in. I think they will have the same formula, but this one I'm definitely keeping. I love this. This is so, so good. The next one is this from NYX. This is a Strobe of Genius. This is kind of an old palette. This was one also of the first highlighter palettes I bought. I think I bought this because it was on sale and a lot of Swedish beauty YouTubers raved about this. I haven't used it that much. I love this shade. This is really, really good. That one I haven't used. As you can see, not all of these will suit me. So I think that NYX tried to do like a highlight palette that could suit a lot of people. And I guess that that isn't that hard with this many shades. But the shade I love looks like this. But I actually think that this will go. Because I think this survived the cluttering. And I haven't used it since, so I actually will decluttering this one as well. And where the hell did I put the other one that I was going to declutter? Weird. So this will go, but if you find this and you want a lot of different highlighters, try it because they are good. It's just not my... I have other things that I love more, and this just take up space in my makeup drawer. And we can take these two at the same time. These are my only two glow kits from Anastasia Beverly Hills. First, I bought this Aurora glow kit. It looks like this. This is not my favorite. I cannot use all the shades. So I also bought the Moonchild. It looks like this. I love this one. I can't use all the shades in this either, but I can use more of these. I use them as an inner corner highlight sometimes, the shades that are too dark for a highlight for me. But I really liked both of these, the Moonshine most, but also the Aurora, because it is something other than I think Anastasia Beverly Hills is doing right now. So I can take my favorite and this one, and I actually think it is Luna. This one, it looks like this. And I don't think these are too glittery. I hear that a lot with Anastasia Beverly Hills glow kit. And in this one, my favorite is Pink Heart. I could buy like the whole palette only for Pink Heart. This is, Pink Heart is a really, really pink highlighter. And I just love it. I'm so happy that I bought Moonchild because this is discontinued. I think the Aurora might be as well. But I think Moonchild was the limited edition one. I don't get it. I think they should have kept this one because I think it's nothing like they have in their normal collection, their normal things. So I think they should have kept the Moonchild. But I'm keeping both of these because I like them, not just like all the colors, because I can't use all the colors. Next up, we have palettes that are mixed, and I am going to start with the newest one. This is the Lethal, or one of the Lethal palettes. I bought one of the pre-made palettes, and this is in Buril, and this is for very light and fair skin. It looks like this. This had the exclusive highlighter, I think it was, at least. You can only buy the highlighter in this little palette. And I really like this highlighter. I used it in Get Ready With Me, where I tested this out. I think they have done a really good job. I don't know though if I like this bronzer shade, because I do not bronze. I contour a little bit. I do not bronze. But I really like this one, and I love that Lethal doing this as well. I think it is so fun, and it's so smart that you can build your own little face palette and have it in a palette. It looks like this. So I'm definitely keeping this. I've had it for like 2 weeks, so yeah, it's a keeper. Another mixed palette that is one of the most expensive things I have in my collection. This is the Natasha Denona Bloom palette. This is the only thing I have from Natasha Denona, and I bought this mainly because Paulina Beauty raved about this and some of my other friends. So this has two creams up here and then two powders down here. I think this is a good one, but it is not a favorite, and I don't think it is worth the price. I bought it 20% off. I wouldn't have bought it for full price. I think it's good, but it's nothing like super special amazing. This one is a really nice blush, and this is, I use it as kind of blush and a highlighter and a blush. These are a little bit too dark for me, or this is a little bit too dark for me to use as a highlighter. I can use it as a blush topper, but yeah, I think it's good, but it is not a favorite. And that sucks a little bit because it's the most expensive thing I have. Almost. But I'm going to keep it either way. And then I also have this little contour palette from Kaleidos. I have it in Cool Light, and I also got this in PR. I love this one. I use this shade for contour like every damn darn time I do my makeup since I got this one. And I just love this. This is an amazing little palette. And they came out with 3 different ones. So one for light skin, medium and deep. I got all 3 in PR. I have this one left and this is the one I use. So yeah, I think this is an amazing palette. And if you're buying from Kaleidos, buy this one because I think you're going to love it. Then the last 2 things I want to show you. One is not like a face palette, but I use it for my face. And it is the Linda Hallberg Infinity Palette. And this is the most used thing I have in my collection, I think. It looks like this. So this is the original Infinity Palette. I love this. This cigar I used for my brows. That is because it's almost empty. Sometimes I use cigar and Maffei, mostly Maffei, and then I blend in a little bit cigar to do my contour. It works really, really good. These 2 are amazing as blushes. I love this Andromeda. And these 2 highlighters, I think you can see which one I've used the most. Milky Way. I love this. I can actually swatch it for you. Maybe I shouldn't make the pan any bigger, but this Milky Way, it is just a perfect highlight. And I often use this when I'm just going to have an easygoing base and nothing more. And this is a palette. When I go home to my parents to visit, I usually bring this because I have everything. So this one I really, really love, as you can see. And yeah, definitely keeping this one. And then the last thing that isn't a palette, but it's a my palette. This is my face palette that I have put all my face powders in. And as you can see, it's a lot from Nabla. And I love this one. So here I have my 3 contour shades. So it is from Makeup Geek, Nabla, and NYX. Here I have highlighters. It's H&M, Nabla, and Nabla. This is one of my all-time favorite highlighters. Down here I have blushes. These 3 are from Nabla. This one is from Lethal. I used that in Get Red With Me. Really, really loving it. And these 3 are from Makeup Store. And I love this palette. I use this a lot, but I don't think I've shown you this in any of my videos. Maybe 1 or 2. But I haven't liked talk about that much. But I love this one. Nabla is doing some of my absolute favorite blushes and highlighters. And I can really recommend you, if you're going to buy some single blushes and stuff like that, buy a big ass palette that you can put everything in. This palette makes me happy. I really love it. And this I also take if I have a little more space to pack makeup in. I take this with me, and this is just a big empty C palette. I think this is amazing and I love this. I have this at my makeup table and I use it quite a lot, even though you're not seeing it. So I just wanted to show you this, and I'm keeping all of this because this is my little baby. I love it. So that was all for that decluttering. It feels good, even though I didn't declutter that much. It just feels good to have done something, and I actually like doing these collection videos. It will come an eyeshadow palette collection. I don't know if it will come this year or if it will come in January, because I'm always waiting for 1 or 2 palettes. But yeah, I really hope that you like this video, and don't forget to subscribe. I will try to upload each and every day now in December, so I hope I'll see you tomorrow. Bye!